These are oyster shell bags for a project we've got called Oyster Gardening, where we give volunteers around the bay oysters to raise off their piers and docks and seawalls. We'll just fill this tank with oyster larvae and they'll set all over the shell, and we'll get thousands of oysters out of one bag of this oyster shell. This is a method we use for any kind of restoration project and for our oyster gardening project.
We're at a gardening site here on County Road 1, and we're loading the gardener shells. These adult oyster shells contain dozens of small oysters or spat. They've got four gardens like this, about 100 shells, so we divide them up about 25 per garden, and they'll start gardening effective today. They'll clean them each week, and in November, we'll come back and collect them all, and all these small dime and quarter size oysters will be on average about 2.5 inches. We'll take them and we'll go out and we'll plant them in restoration resites around the bay and in Mississippi Sound.
We'll put them in, we suspend them about a foot off the bottom. If we put them on the bottom, critters will get in there, predators, especially at this small stage when they're so young. That's one reason we take them out once a week and try to get the algae off of them and get the baby crabs and things like that that will get in here. And this is already tied on and it's suspended about a foot off the bottom. I'm now gardening.
So oyster gardening is, of course, a volunteer-based program. Our gardeners and our adopters are really the driving forces behind the program. We get a great amount of support from our partner agencies, the Mississippi-Alabama Sea Grant Consortium, the Alabama Cooperative Extension System, the Mobile Bay National Estuary Program, Auburn University Shellfish Lab. They all work together with us to help oyster gardening happen, and the combination of that partnership with the gardeners really is what allows this program to go on.